My name is Bert van Son. I started a company 8 years ago with the idea of changing the fashion industry, because we all know now that the fashion industry is a horrible industry. It's the second largest polluter in the world, and I would like to change that. There you go. So the problem starts with the cotton. I think we all know now that it's a huge polluter. It leaves a lot of water, and often in places where there's not much water. 24 billion kilos of cotton are produced every year, and much of that is just used very shortly and then thrown away or burned. In Holland, here you see how it's grown. People are not protected. It's really not a good idea. And here you see the Aral Sea. Who knows the Aral Sea in Uzbekistan? Anybody? Okay, so I have a lot to say. It used to be the Aral Sea in Uzbekistan, and it's all gone. And in the financial world, people would call this a stranded asset. In Holland, we burn 182 million kilos of clothing, and that's not good. I don't know the figures of France, but it's going to be huge also. It's either burnt or landfilled, and that's raw material that can be reused. But it's not easy. If you want to reuse material, you have to make sure that you separate it. So, for instance, wool is a very good material to regenerate and reuse, and it's happening. And cotton also. We found out that cotton is very much reusable. You can imagine it's sort of like the paper industry. Hello, welcome. Have a seat. Come on, we have a full scale thing. So cotton can be reused, but you have to make sure that you separate it well and that you have at least 98% raw cotton. So here are all the figures. To give you an idea, one garbage truck full of textiles is being trashed every second in the world. So honestly, it's a huge problem, and we want to change that. But the good news is cotton can be reused, but it's not easy. So what we've done is saying, okay, we make beautiful jeans in proper factories, which I will show you later. We try to use organic cotton, which is not always easy because you have to get the right certification. We use GOTS, G-O-T-S, the Global Organic Textile Standard. But even that, sometimes it's difficult to trace and to be sure from which farm it comes and if it's really well made. So what we do is we make our jeans in a way that we know that one day we will get them back, and we try to make it easy for ourselves to recycle it. So to give you an idea, we call that circular design. And 8 years ago, the circular economy was a trending word. It was all new. Luckily today, everybody knows what it is and knows how it works. We started 8 years ago by designing our jeans in a circular way. For instance, by not using leather labels. Here you see the example. I think it looks even quite well. And the funny thing was that in Germany, the big United PETA, the vegan society, thought that we were very good because we didn't use leather, we use organic cotton, and on and on and on. So we are PETA approved in Germany, and that gives us a big boost because the vegan society is growing and very enthusiastic about our jeans. The other thing we use are the buttons. They are now stainless steel, so one material. Before we had a piece of plastic in it and some other materials, which makes it more difficult to recycle. This is very easy to recycle. The water that we still use in our factory is being regenerated by reversed osmosis. That's like the same technique that you make salt water really drinkable. And it's important because water is an important topic. And the indigo, the dye stuff we use nowadays, is non-toxic indigo. Whereas before, the blue dye stuff indigo is very dirty stuff. And I had my friend William McDonough from Cradle to Cradle call me 3 years ago, and he said, Bert, I'm a big fan, but you're recycling toxic material, and that's not a good idea. So during those 8 years, we had a lot of lessons, a lot of people calling us and talking to us and saying, maybe you can improve this, maybe you can do that, and that it really helps. And then, of course, we have to think about, we make these beautiful jeans, we've been thinking about the design, but how do I get them back? and there's an easy system. I can give you a discount for 10 euros when you buy a new pair of jeans, and you can bring your old jeans. And we started off with our own jeans, of course, because they're organic cotton and they're good. But that was so small that we thought, okay, we have to open this up for everybody. And so now we accept your dirty jeans, as long as they have 95% cotton. And normally we've done some research. About 20 washings, all the dirty stuff is gone and we can reuse it. So we count on that. But the other thing is you can lease a pair of jeans from us for 750 a month. And in 2012, this was spectacular news for the papers and everybody, which is, of course, small. It was nice when you start a small company that suddenly everybody talks about you. And it even went up to the Wall Street Journal, which I'm very proud of still. So this story really picked up, and we suddenly had more than 1,000 leasers, and we were not at all ready for this. Our back office, you know, we have to take 750 from your account, and we have to make sure that all the IT is working. It was a nightmare, I have to admit. And after 3 months, I had friends of mine calling me, very enthusiastic, saying, Bert, it's a really nice idea, your leaser jeans, but you don't take any money from my account, so it's not going to work like this. So we've solved that during the years, but it's still a challenge to do it right. But it works now well, and we have today more than 4,000 leasers, really enthusiastic people that want to be part of this movement, that enjoy wearing our jeans and that talk about our jeans. They share it on Instagram. So it's a good idea. You know, we don't have big budgets for marketing, but people talk about us. And this is even stronger, I think, than big marketing budgets. So what do you do then? We get those jeans back. And in 2014, we had many of our customers saying, okay, are you really going to recycle that? How do you do this? What's happening? So we decided to make a tour, and we filled up two old cars with a lot of stinking jeans, and we drove through France because this recycle machine is, or this whole factory, is in Spain, Valencia. And on the trip, we had a lot of fun. We did nice things. We had a beach cleanup with the Surf Riders Foundation and the University of Troye. And we came there to see how this works. This is the first step, shredding it. We have a shredder here on the stand, so come and see us. We show in small type how jeans is shredded. That's the first step of the regenerating of the cotton. Then it becomes like a sort of bluish cotton thing again. We have to mix it then with new organic cotton. The best we can do today is 40% post-consumer waste. So please listen well, because a lot of people use cutting losses, which is good. But using old jeans is really a bigger challenge. And we also don't want to put plastics in it, because it's nice to use plastic because it's a long thread. But if you use cotton and plastic together, you create a material that's not usable anymore. So we want to stick to our cotton. We add new organic cotton, and we make new jeans. So 40-60 is the best we can do. And we promise the world this year that we will come up with 100% post-consumer waste jeans. We are working on it. We did the first test three days ago. Our engineer is working on it. And we have two techniques. It's called molecular recycling cotton and mechanically recycling cotton. That's what you see here. And next year I'll come back to show you the result. And I have a neat small movie of that, of our trip to Valencia, where you can see how nice it is to be into that budget. this. Thank you. This movie is already outdated because you saw the old-fashioned way of dyeing the indigo in seven layers of water. Today we dye with, it's called mist dye, flow dye, and uses a lot less water. So again, there, you know, every technique that comes up, we try to use it. So this material then goes to Tunisia. You might say, Spain, Tunisia, why don't you do all in Holland? It would be better, but I can tell you in the fashion industry, this is a very small circle. Normally, jeans go from left to right, from China to Bangladesh, and I don't know what. So this is really already a big improvement. So we save 92% of water. We save so far nearly 70% of CO2 emission compared to a normal pair of jeans. And like I said, we can go up today up to 40%, and this will also improve, I promise you. So then this material goes to Tunisia, to a factory, a very special factory, a gentleman who founded this factory 20 years ago, and after the revolution in Tunisia decided to stay with his money and say, I feel responsible for the 1,000 people that work here, and I want to invest in my company. So in the jeans industry, again, you have the cutting and the sewing, but then there's the big part of bleaching and giving the jeans the look that they are worn. And there are also new kind of techniques, like laser, which I will show you later. And the bleaching is done by ozone, O3. So again, all those steps can be improved. And I also there want to show you a small movie. This is the way we do this lasering. Quite impressive. And the advantage here is that the material is not broken. Normally they use sandpaper and chemicals, potassium permanganate, horrible stuff. And the yarn even gets broken. So our jeans last much longer by this process. We just burn away a little bit of the dye. And then your bum looks even better. Thank you. So we were there 2 years ago again. We said to the world, let's show what we do and let's try to film it with our own images to be sure that it all goes well, that the people are happy making our jeans, that our colleagues who make this are well treated, well insured, work in a beautiful environment. And this is how it looks. This is our denim guru explaining to the team how this is all done. And I again have a small movie there. I hope. There you go. All my world begin to howl. Wake me up, the time is now. Ooh, can you hear the drumming? There's a revolution coming. I have things that turn me on. Drag my dark into the dark. Ooh, can you hear the drumming? Ooh, there's a revolution coming. There's a revolution coming. Is there anything special you see in this movie? Something that you see? No? I would say laughing people, but okay. Maybe it's only me. This is Eustex in Monastir, a beautiful company, and we are very proud to work there. It's all open source. We've written a 78-page sustainability report where we tell what we do and where we do it. Please read it. And one of the targets of our company is, of course, we want to grow ourselves, and it's what we do. But we also want the bigger and larger jeans companies to have a look at this. And we want to show them that it is possible to make a proper pair of jeans. And please copy it and start doing it also. But then you have to sell your jeans, right? That's not easy. Who's wearing a mud jeans here? In the one. That's a friend of mine. That's not fair. And you also. And you, Thomas, where's your mud jeans? Come on. So how do you find your audience? It's very difficult because you're a small company, you don't have budgets, you're starting. Who likes this? So of course we are lucky now. We have social media. We have 36,000 followers on social media, on Instagram. So please all take your phones and followers on Instagram. That's 100 extra. You did, Cyril, good. That's what we need. And we try to show there also what we do and how we do it. We call them, the audience, the cultural creative. That's somebody who likes change, is well educated, has children, likes to travel. And of course, we try to target them. And they also like a healthy lifestyle. So we see that a lot of people that are vegan love our jeans because they are approved vegan. And that's a movement, especially in Germany, this really works well. We just started with an agent in France this January. So the French market is going to be there soon. Already two stores in Paris, Nantes, Rennes, Lyon, Montpellier. Donc, we're good. So that's what we like to go. And we think this is important. And that goes for a lot of things. I like this model a lot. And for instance, Switzerland, you feel that the good is a new coal model is really starting to work. It's not anymore I wear this pair of jeans because I think their advertisement is beautiful and there's a beautiful guy stepping out of an airplane and showing his jeans. No, this is what people want today. We are convinced about it. So you have to know your purpose. You have to find your allies. You have to think about citizens, not consumers. We have to lead with the cool. Anybody cool here? I would like to lead with us. Good. We don't want to advertise. We want to solve problems. We think that people are the new media. There's a small thing on our website called Get Rewarded, where we ask you to take pictures from our jeans, to leave reviews on Google for us. All those things are building our brand. And we have to back it up with the promise, with the proof. And that's what we're doing. We teamed up 2 years ago with a company called EcoChain, very expensive. And they, with the blockchain technology, they put everything together for us. Every step we do is proven. So we don't need any certifications. We can just trace and show you what we are doing. And we are even going a little bit further, because as from next year, we will put a small yarn with a DNA traceability, so we can prove that the recycled yarn is coming back in the next genes. So we hope this is going to work. What else do we do? Let me see. Oh yeah, this is an example of some of our enthusiastic customers.
We are at the pass of Kandala, at 4,900 meters of altitude. We are doing a trek in the Himalaya mountains. And look with what we are trekking.
Yeah, there you go.
The Mergins! I think it's definitely the higher Mergins in the world. Greetings from India, Ladakh. Cheers!
So we also believe we are the higher genes in the world. And I think they were also high of altitude. But they are the guys from Circulaire. And I gave them two pairs of jeans, one pair each. And they traveled 18 months around the world to find circular startups. And they came back with their jeans. We put them into encadrement. Because they were torn away, they were used like crazy, but really beautiful. The other thing we do, and that's also with the start of our company, we were in 2013 one of the first companies to become a B Corp. We're very proud of that. A B Corp means that you fix in your the startup of your company the line saying, we want to make money, but we don't want to do it against humanity or against nature. And we want to safeguard everything we do and be careful. I like the slogan a lot. It's use your business as a force for good. And you have to sign the Declaration of Interdependence. There's a stand from B Corp here. Go there, have a look, talk with them, because I feel it's really interesting. And it's a must for companies to become a B Corp. And we've joined them also with the Net Zero program for 2030. You can find all this on the internet. I'll let you take the pictures and then keep going. But even then, you know, you can do much more. Maybe like me and you, you don't like these small buses driving around like crazy in your cities or in your street. DHL, DPD, we don't want that. So we decided this year to deliver in 33 cities in Holland with Fietscourier. That's Dutch for bicycle courier, I don't know. And so they deliver our jeans. And the good thing is that your customers, they receive our jeans in a repack by bike, and they are so enthusiastic that they put this on Twitter and Instagram. Again, it helps building the brand. So you're doing something good that you think, but it also helps yourself building your brand. So I can advise you to do that. Then this summer, we decided to join forces with Sea Shepherd. We made a collection with them together. It's also now for sale at the Sea Shepherd store in Paris. We did a beach cleanup with them together, the regenerative festival. And it was, again, we learn a lot. I didn't know anything about fishery, but if you talk to these guys, you are flabbergasted because it's incredible what happens in the sea, but I'll leave that to others to talk about. But it's a good collaboration. Again, they have 500,000 followers on the Instagram, and it helps, again, building the brand. So we want you, and I hope you will do that for us, make this movement stronger, try to consume in a different way. We give you the option to have a fair, beautiful pair of jeans. And the funny thing is that people try my jeans and they put them on and they go like, oh, wow, they even fit well. And I cannot understand it, because why would they not fit well, right? Can anybody explain that to me? No? So there you go. Please, thank you for your attention.